Good morning, everyone. See, in our previous class, we discussed about the economic environment in India. In that, we discussed the various macroeconomic factors that are going to be affect on the business. What are all the macroeconomic factors, which includes the stages of development of a country? When it comes to the stages of development of country, whether the country is developed country or whether the country is underdeveloped or developing country, these are all the factors will going to be affect on the business performance. And also other factors like economic policies, economic plans, and also infrastructural facilities, and also economic structure. These are all some of the macro factors that are going to be affect on the business. So this is all some of the micro factors that are going to be affect on the business. These are all the factors having some of the impact or importance in the business performance. And also we discuss about the at the time of independence, what was our economic condition. That is also we discussed in our previous class. And also we were discussing about the new economic policy, right? We were discussing about the new economic policy, or we can call it as new economic reforms. When it was introduced? It was introduced in the year of 1991 by the government of India. It was introduced by the government of India in the year of 1991. So this new economic reform or this new economic policy will stand by the three elements. What are all the three elements? That is LPG. What is LPG? Liberalization, privatization, and globalization. So these are all the things we already discussed in our previous class. And also we discussed about the what is liberalization also. So well, then what is liberalization? So when it comes to the liberalization, here we are going to remove the unnecessary trade practices or unnecessary trade restriction. So in trading, enella restrictions irutho, unnecessary restriction irutho, we are going to remove the all those restrictions, okay, for the purpose of increasing the competence. And also in liberalization, we made liberalization of industries which is relating to the licensing. So licensing allu kuda nave en madidvi, liberalization annodu madidvi. So initially enagtittu, for every industries they have to take the license for startup of any business start madbeku andre they have to take the license. But after the liberalization, except some shortlisted industries or shortlisted companies na madidru, except this, if we want to start any business, means you can start. There is no need to take the permission or no need to take the license from the government. So this was happened in the liberalization, okay. And also in liberalization, due to the liberalization, it is going to be attract the foreign direct investment. So liberalization in the enaitu foreign direct investment anno jaasti aitu, and also it will increases the technology also, because there is no such restrictions on the trade as well as the licensing. So that it is happened in the, this is also one of the a new economic reform in order to develop our economy, in order to boost of our economy. The government of India has introduced the liberalization, okay. These are all the things we already discussed, right? So in this class we will discuss the further concept, that is what is privatization and what is globalization. So when it comes to the privatization, so privatization is also one of the new economic reforms which was introduced in the year of 1991. This is also one of the pillar of the new economic reform. Hagare, what is privatization? Privatization is nothing but ownership of a public enterprises can be transferred to the public sector. Okay, here ownership of public control to private control. That is called private privatization. In privatization alli enaitu public sector alli public control alli ididella public sector control alli ididella private sector control ig aitu adin en antivi privatization. They introduced the privatization in order to boost up of our economy. Hagare how it will going to be boost up of our economy means, so in the at the time of 1991, so before 1991 what will happen means most of the industries are reserved for the public sector only. Ella most of the resources industries enagittu public sector alle ittu. But after the 1991, after this they identify the role which is performed by the private sector in order to develop the nation, in order to build the nation, they identify the role which is performed by the private sector, so that they give an importance for the private sector. Okay, they give the importance after new economic policy, they gives the importance for the private sector. Okay, and also say for example, if all the industries which is controlled by the government sector means, if which is controlled by the public sector means, what will happen? It will going to create the monopolistic market, alva. So ella industry nu government undertaking gallidre there is no importance for the private industries or private sector ge importance iradilla. Hangagi that will creates the what monopolistic market. As you know that what is monopolistic market, so monopolistic market alle enagutte, there is a single seller and many more buyers, alva. So idralli monopolistic market alli there is no competition. We have to accept what the seller is selling. Seller en sell martidano now adan accept madbekagutte. We should not question out of that, alva. So that it will leads to the early monopolistic market. Say for example, like electricity energy. So electricity na manegella yar kodtare, the public sector, that is government will going to give the electricity to every home or every organization, they are going to supply, alva. So ee services enagutte government ene madidru we have to accept that, because for electricity supply there is no competitor for the electricity supply, alva. So that we have to accept what the government is going to giving, alva. So that it will leads to the monopolistic market. But when the privatization was happened, there was an increase in the competition anadu jaasti agutte. Say for example, like networking. So networking al tagondre there are many companies are offering the networking facilities, alva. For example, like Jio, Airtel and Idea, Vodafone, these are all the some of the networking companies we are going to offer the networking facilities. And also in between the companies also there are more competition. If there is a competition in between the sellers, who will get benefited out of this? The customer will going to get benefited out of this, because they are going to get the more quality product with a reasonable price, and also the customer having the more choice also. Likewise it will going to be happened in the privatization. If we made the privatization madidke enaitu, the competition anu jaasti aitu. Competition jaasti aagtidre enagutte, so it will increases the, so the customers will going to get the more products choice anadu customers ge sigutte. Quality products with a reasonable price ge tagoladukke it will the customer will get benefited out of this, alva. Likewise the privatization was introduced in the new economic policy of 1991, and also in order to convert the government company or the public company into the private company, there are two ways. Okay, there are two ways to convert the public company into the private company. Public company in the private company ke badlaisbeku andre, there are two ways. What are all those two ways? The first one is, let me write, two ways to convert the public company into private company, because here we are going to give the more importance for the private sector when it comes to the privatization, Alva. So how we can convert? The first one way is disinvestment or removal of 51% of shares from the government. Okay, first one is about disinvestment made by the government or removal of 51% of shares from the government. Through this we can also convert the public sector into the private sector. Say for example, if any industry, in any industry, if the public company or the if the government having 51% of shares, means the majority of shares which is belongs to the government only, Alva. Government kaiyalle majority shares, that is 51% shares ide, 51% shares idage enagutte, major controlling agli, decision agli, which is within the hand of the government sector only, Alva. So that the government will going to be disinvesting in the any industries. Yavade industry alli ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟು ಡಿಸ್ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂದರೆ 51%ಗಿಂತ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ದ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಅಂದರೆ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ಲಿ 51% ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಮೆಜಾರಿಟಿ ಶೇರ್ಸು ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟಿಂದ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟಿಂದ ಮೆಜಾರಿಟಿ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಆದರೆ ಆ ಕಂಪನಿಯ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲಿಂಗ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಲಿ, ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲಿಂಗ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಯಾರ ಕಡೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಕಡೆನೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಆದ್ರಿಂದ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಎನ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡಿಸ್ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್. ದ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ರಿಮೂವ್ ದೇರ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್. ಅವ್ರು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ 51% ಶೇರ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಲೆಸ್ ದನ್ 51% ಶೇರ್ಸ್, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವೇ. ಓಕೆ, ದ ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ವೇ ಈಸ್ ವಿತ್ಡ್ರಾವಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಓನರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೈಸಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿತ್ಡ್ರಾ ಆಫ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿತ್ಡ್ರಾ ಆಫ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಓನರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ business or industry. So in any industry, if the government itself withdrawing its ownership or withdrawing its management, means that is also easily convert into the public sector to the private sector. So government en madute, you know, they are going to take back their ownership na vapas tagulute athwa management and ownership they are going to take back. Through this also they can convert into the, that is public sector company can convert into the private sector. Okay, this is all about the privatization. So initially what will happen means up to 1991, majority of the industries which is belongs to the which is reserved for the public sector only, but after the privatization they gives permission for the all the private sector to start up the business, except the three industries, that is first one is about the railways, atomic energy and as well as the defense. So these three, except these three industries, the government make a privatization. Okay, except three things yav yav ide, ಇವಾಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಈ ಮೂರು ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ಲೂ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಈ ಮೂರು ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಯಾವುದು? ರೈಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ರೈಲ್ವೇಸ್ ನೌ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಆಟೋಮಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದ ಡಿಫೆನ್ಸ್, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ತ್ರೀ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್. ನೌ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟೈಸೇಷನ್. In simple, this the main aim of privatization is giving to great importance to the private sector. We have to, in privatization, they want to give the more importance to the private sector and reduce the importance or reduce the role of a public sector. That was happened in the privatization. Okay, this is all about the privatization. Okay, this is also one of the economic reform which was introduced in the year of 1991. And the last pillar of this new economic policy is about the what? Globalization. By the globalization. Globalization is nothing but we are going to opening up of our economy into the world economy. That is called it as a globalization. Globalization means what? Opening up of our economy into world economy is called globalization. How we are going to opening up of our economy into the world economy means, so here we are going to interacting with the other countries' economy by doing the trades and also by spreading the products, by spreading the investment, and also by spreading the technology across the border. We are going to spreading all these things. So through this we are going to make the globalization, or we are going to trading with the other countries' economy. That is called it as a privatization. So that is called it as a globalization. Okay, so up to 1991, what will happen means, up to 1991 enitu, that is national market agli, local market annadu ittu, but now it is an international market. That is, after 1991 we can call it as an international market, because other countries' product are also available in our country also, alva. So our country product is available for other country also. Likewise, the globe itself considered as a country. So now country anta India anta adakagala, in globalization alli enagutte, the globe itself considered as a country, because through the globalization we are going to interacting with the other country's economy by spreading the products, by spreading the investment, and also by spreading the technology across the border. We are going to call it as a globe, as a country. For example, like take a product. So as you know, that product, other country's product is available in our country also, right? How it will happen? Through the globalization only it is going to be happen. And also when it comes to the investment also, so when it comes to the investment, we make a liberalization in our economy. So if we done the liberalization in our economy, that will leads to the what? That will attracts the other countries, MNC companies, to invest in our company or invest in the Indian economy. Alva, Indian company alli invest madodike they are going to be attract, alva. So through the globalization we can spreading the investment also. Now en madabodu, nam Indian company bere country alliro company alli investment madabodu, and other country alliro companies Indian company alli invest madabodu. That is called it as foreign direct investment, alva. And also when it comes to the technology also, technology also we can easily transfer because of the globalization. Say for example, technology hek transfer agutte antandre, say for example, if we don't want to ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಅದರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿಯಿಂದ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಅಥವಾ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದಾಗ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ದ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಪರ್ಚೇಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ದ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿನ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡಸ್ಟರ್ ಅಂತಲೇ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ ಸೊ ಈ ಡಸ್ಟರ್ನ ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನೇನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ರಾ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಯಾವ ಮೆಥಡಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಲೈಕ್ ವೈಸ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿನ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿನ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಂಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ಲೇ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಸೊ ದ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾಪೆಂಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ಬೇರೆ ಕಂಟ್ರಿಯಿಂದ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಬರ್ತಿದೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಇದಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ಯಾವ್ದು ಕಾರಣ ಆಯಿತು ಗ್ಲೋಬಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ನಾವು ಗ್ಲೋಬಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಅಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಟು ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಓಕೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಪರೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇಫ್ ಎನಿ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಆರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಎನಿ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಆರ್ ದ ಕಂಪನಿ ಆರ್ ದ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೈಸಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಆಪರೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಎಕಾನಮಿ ಆರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಪರೇಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಆಪರೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಓಮ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆಪರೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಓಕೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಬರೀ ಹೋಮ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ಲೇ ಅದ್ರ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಲಿದ್ದಂಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಬರೀ ಇನ್ ಹೋಮ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ದಂಗೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕಂಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಅಥವಾ ಬೇರೆ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಏನಾದರೂ ಅದ್ರ ಬ್ರಾಂಚಸ್ ಇದ್ದು ಅದ್ರ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ನಡೀತಿದೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತ ಅಂದಾಗ ಅದನ್ನೇನಂತೀವಿ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅನ್ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಎ ಕಂಪನಿ ಸೊ ಈ ಕಂಪನಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಪರೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಸೊ ಇಂಡಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಆಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಆಪರೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆಪರೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಫ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ USA UK Likewise, if it is operating in this country also, this is also called it as a globalization, okay? And up to 1991, there are so many restrictions on the import and export and the quality restrictions also there. Up to 1991, enitu? ಸೊ ಇಂಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಲೈಸೆನ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ರಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಇಂಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಲೈಸೆನ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಅಲ್ಲ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ರಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್ ಬಟ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 1991 ದೀಸ್ ರಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ರಿಮೂವ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ದ ಇಂಟರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಇಂಟರ್ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಓಕೆ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ದ ಇಂಟರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎರಡು ದೇಶಗಳ ನಡುವೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಇಂಟರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಇಂಟರ್ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಇಂಟರ್ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ದ ಇಂಟರ್ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆನ್ಸಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಫಾರ್ ಡಿಫೆನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಶಕ್ಕೆ ಡಿಫೆನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಯಾವ ಕಂಟ್ರಿನ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಅದರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ನ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಲೈಕ್ ಫ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ USA ಆಗಲಿ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಲೈಕ್ ವೈಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ ವಾಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದ ಡಿಫೆನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಬಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಲೈಕ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಸ್ಪೈಸಿ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಪೈಸಿ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಆಯುರ್ವೇದಿಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ದ ಅದರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಮೇಲೆ ಅದರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ವೈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಒನ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಟು ಇಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ವೈಸ್ ದ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ದ ಇಂಟರ್ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಇಂಟರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋ ಸಚ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಬಾರ್ಡರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋ ಸಚ್ ಜಿಯೋಗ್ರಫಿಕಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಪ್ ಆರ್ ದ political borders removed due to the globalization. Globalization in the ಏನಾಯ್ತು physical gap ಅಥವಾ geographical gap ಅನ್ನೋದು it has been removed because the other countries product are available right now ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ನಮಗೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ಬೇರೆ ಕಂಟ್ರೀದು ಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಅವೈಲಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟು ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕಂಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ಲೂ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅವೈಲಬಲ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅವೈಲಬಲ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ಲೈಕ್ ಲಿಬರಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅಚೀವ್ ದ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲೈಸೇಷನ್. ಓಕೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ದ ಟ್ರೂಲಿ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅ ಫ್ರೀ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಫ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದ ನೇಷನ್. ದೇರ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅ ಫ್ರೀ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಫ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ದೇರ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅ ಫ್ರೀ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದ ನೇಷನ್. ದೇರ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅ ಫ್ರೀ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಫ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದ ನೇಷನ್. ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅವೈಲಬಲ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಥ್ರೂ ಔಟ್ ದ ನೇಷನ್. ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಅವೈಲಬಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅವೈಲಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಫ್ರೀ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆರ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಮೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಒನ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಟು ದ ಅನದರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ. ಏನು ಮೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇರಬೇಕು ಅಥವಾ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಮೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಒನ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಟು ದ ಅನದರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ which has happened only due to the globalization. Okay, this is all about the new economic policy. So in the new economic policy, when it was introduced, it is introduced in the year of 1991 by the government of India. Why they are going to be introduced, for what purpose? For the purpose of boosting up of our economy. Namma economy na boost up madakke they introduced the new economic policy. This new economic policy of 1991, which is stand by the three things, which is stand by the three pillars, that is called it as an liberalization, privatization and globalization. So in liberalization, what will happen means they are going to remove the restrictions on trade, and also they remove the restrictions on the licensing also. If there is any unnecessary restrictions, that has been removed in the liberalization. Okay, when it comes to the privatization, so they gave more importance for the private sector, and also in order to build the nation or in order to develop the nation, they recognize the importance of the privatization. In privatization, privatization is nothing but ownership of a public sector is transferred to the private sector. That is called it as an privatization. Okay, when it comes to the globalization is nothing but here we are going to interacting with the other country's economy. The whole country is treated as what? The whole country is treated as a nation. Okay, and also here we are going to interacting with the other country's economy, as well as we are going to spreading up of our capital, or we are going to spreading up of our investment products as well as the technology in the globalization. This is all about the new economic policy in the year of 1991. And also we have to discuss the last concept of your third unit, that is impact of government policies changes on the industry or the business. ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಗೆ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಲಿಸೀಸ್ ಏನೆಲ್ಲ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ ಅದು ಹೇಗೆ ಇಂಪ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಯೋರ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್. ಓಕೆ
ಇಂಪ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಲಿಸೀಸ್ changing the business. Okay, what are all the impact of government policies changes? If the government policies get changed, means
how it will going to impact on the performance of a business. Especially we are going to change the government policy change means which specially which is refers to the LPG. So LPG introduce agidrinda government policy andu which specially LPG, okay? LPG introduce madidrinda namma business athwa nam business performance ge enella impact aitu that we have to discuss in this thing, okay? By the new policy which is announced by the government, which is established by the government in the year of 1991, that is LPG introduced madidrinda enaitu, it is having its significant importance on the working enterprises. It is having the significant importance of the working enterprises and also the Indian corporate sector has faces the several challenges only due to the changes in the government policies. So government policies alli changes adrinda enaitu the industries or the Indian corporate sector has to face the several challenges. Industry athwa corporate sector, Indian corporate sector enaitu that has to face the several challenges because of changes in the government policies. Agare what are all the challenges which is faced by the corporate sector that we have to discuss, okay? The first one challenge is about the increasing the competition. The first one is increase . So this is also one of the challenges which is faced by the business. See, in earlier before 1991, what is our market condition? It is just like a local market, or it is like a up to national level. We can up to national level market was there before 1991. But after 1991, due to the LPG or due to the introducing the new economic reforms, that is liberalization, privatization and globalization, it can become as a international market. Ivagirodu international market, not local market or national market. Now it is an international market, okay? So in international market we made an liberalization which is relating to the licensing. We made the liberalization and also the companies are become as an globalized because there is an opportunity for the other countries business to invest in the Indian company will invest madok opportunity kodvi. At the same time Indian company has also having the opportunity to invest in the other countries business. Bere country alliro business athwa organization alli invest madodike Indian company gu eno opportunity siktu. Likewise it will going to be increase the competition because the foreign companies or MNC companies are established in India alva. Due to the LPG enaitu liberalization madidvi, privatization madidvi, globalization madidvi, idrinda enaitu other countries athwa MNC company enaitu India dalli easy agi establish madodik shuru madidru. And also Indian company it is like a competition alva. So Indian company en martu they have to competed with the foreign companies or they have to competed with the MNC company jothe they have to compete alva. So through this it will going to be increase the competition. Now liberalize madidvi, privatization madidvi, globalization madidvi, idrinda enaitu foreign company athwa MNC company galu india dalli establish adrinda enaitu India dalli iro company ge enaitu it is like a competitor adru alva. Likewise it will going to increase the competition. And also especially in the service sector they have increases, okay? Especially in the service industries like telecommunication, the airlines, banking, insurance, etc., which these are all the industries. Now initially there was in the under the public sector. So ELI industries before 1991, they are in within the what they are in the public sector. Public sector agittu. But after 1991, privatization aitu. So majorly these are all the competition anodu e industry, especially service industry al jaasti aitu. Yava service industry antandre telecommunication, banking, insurance, airlines, etc. This is likewise it will going to be increase the competition. This is also one of the challenges which is faced by the Indian corporate sector. Okay, and the next one is about the more demanding customer. More demanding so now the customer are become more demanding. Why means due to the increase in the competition, the various products or services which can be available for the customers, alva. So for example, in an industry like industry is nothing but which is having the same line of production activity, alva. So in like take an example of soap, alva. Take an example of soap. For soap, there are soap is in one of the kind of one type of an industry, alva. Soap industry. So in soap industries, there are many companies were there like Lux, Santoor, Johnson Baby. Likewise, there is many various companies were there. Soap industry alle various companies barutte. So enagutte ee ella companies gal madhya competition annodu it will increases. Competition increase aadaga enagutte who will get benefited out of the competition? The customer will get the benefited of the this competition, because competition jaasti aagtide andre customer ge enagutte they can get the wide choices of the product. Product single soap bage enagutte wide choices annodu sigutte. So the customer can easily buy the or customer can easily buy the quality of goods, better quality of goods with a reasonable price, they can going to be buy. So this has happened only due to the liberalization. Initially enagittu there is one company enaitu aa company product ne purchase maadbekagittu, but ivaga enagide competition anno jaasti aagidide. Competition jaasti aadaga enagutte customer ge wide choices sigutte. So that hence the customer are become is a more demanding customer. So customer demand itakaga we have to produce the goods, alva. So that the customer are becoming the more demanding customer. Say for example, another product helbeku andre like Colgate. Initially en aagtittu Colgate annadu onde company ittu. So paste ig bandaga Colgate anno onde company ittu, we have to purchase, everyone will going to purchase that product only. But after the privatization, globalization and liberalization, there are many more companies was there, alva. Like Patanjali agirbodu, Babul agirbodu, and Colgate alle eno flavors change madidare, colors change madidare. Likewise, they are going to be improve their quality or improve their products. Okay, hence the customer are become, and also the customer are well aware about all these the products and services which is available in the market. Hence the customer are becoming as a more competitive, more demanding. So customer ge ee ella products and services bagge knowledge irodrinda ivaga en aagtidare customer anore en aagtidare they are becoming as a more competitive or sorry more demanding customer aagtidare. This is also one of the impact of government policies, changes in the government policies. Okay, and the next one is about the rapidly changing technological environment. Rapidly changing so as you know that whatever the technology it may be, it is not an constant in nature. The technology which is always the changing in nature, technology anadu enagutte they have the day by day the technology has getting changed, alva. And also so that the company or the business has to adopt technology or adopt these changes in the business, like changes in the like inner technological changes agtide and the machine changes maadbekagutte, and also they have to change the product quality, also they have to make changes, they have to make changes in the service quality, also they have make some changes. At the same time, we have to make the changes in the process of production. In the process also we have to make some changes, because technology is not constant, technology is goes on changing. So that we have to adopt the new way in the machines ugly, new way in the procedures ugly, strategies ugly, planning ugly, strategies ugly. We have to adopt the new changes, because the external environment or technological environment, it is not in constant in nature, that is always in changing in nature. So that according to that changes, the business has to make the changes in the business itself. So for example, the majority of the companies are investing in the research and developing department ge en martare jaasti amount na spend martare, because of new ideas agli, innovation agli introduce madodike, namma product nalli enaru changes madodike, so they are going to be invest more on the research and development. Ivaga companies research and development alle tumba invest martare, so that this is also one of the impact. Okay, and the next one is about the necessity for change. So necessity for change, because as you know that the external environment is always goes on changing, alva. Say for example, whether it is and general factors or whether it is and specific factors, general factors like economical, social, political, legal, technological changes, according to that we have to make the changes in our industry. And also when it comes to the like specific factors like customers, investors, if there is any changes in the taste of the customers, according to that we have to make changes in our business, alva. Likewise, we have to make continuously, we have to modify our operations, the day to day operations na nave en madbekaru, we have to modify according to the changes in the external environment. So initially en aagtitu, before 1991 all the strategies are relatively constant. Before 1991 enagtitu ella industries policies agli, so they are relatively constant agittu, but after 1991 it is goes on changing, alva. So external environment is goes on changing due to the LPG, the external environment is goes on changing. So according to this changes in the external environment, the business has to modify its operations. So this is also one of the impact of the government policy. And the next one is about the need for development of human resources. Need for development of human resources. So the human, as you know that the human resources are the valuable resources in an organization. In yavde organization alli human resources annodu, it is very important resources in the organization, alva. So that we have to improve the, or we have to give an adequate training to the employees, we have to give an adequate training or adequate we have to make the employees in an efficient way, we have to make the more competence to the employees, so that we have to develop the employees. We have to develop the employees. If we develop the employees, so it is not only benefited for the organization or the business, but it is also helpful for the human or the employees also. If we develop the human resources of the organization, that is not only give that is not only helps to the business, but also it is going to be helps to the people's or employees of the organization also, because in organization hege help agutte andre they can get the more effective and efficient work, and also when it comes to the employees ge en aagtidare andre our skills annodu develop aagtide alva. So likewise, if their skills are developing means they are going to get the more remuneration for their work, they can get the more remuneration alva. Likewise, it will going to be develop the human resources. This is also we have to, if the organization want to more competent agirbeku andre the more competent employees irbeku, more competent employees beku andre we have to develop the human resources organization alliro human resources na naavu develop maadbeku, training facilities annadnu kodbeku. Likewise we have, this is also one of the impact of the changes in the government policies. Okay, and the next one is about the market orientation. So when it comes to the market orientation, so in before 1991 what will happen means it is like a product oriented market conditions or product oriented operations annodu itto. Say for example, so before we will go with the selling, we are going to produce the things first. Now en martivi product na produce maadi before 1991 alli now products na produce maadi amel en martidvi selling activities ke hogtidvi, that is called it as a product oriented market athwa product oriented operations. But now the market condition is market orientation. Here first what we are going to do, first we are going to analyze the, we are going to study the market, we are going to analyze the market, according to that only we are going to produce the goods or services. According to the study what we studied, we are going to produce the things. After study the market, we will go with the production activity. So that is called it as an market orientation alva. So this is also one of the impact of the changes in the government policies towards the business. Okay, and the last impact of the government policy